Hey, Deepika is back with a new video and topic of the day is present continuous tense, more popularly known as present progressive tense. First of all, I should tell you where these type of sentences are used. Dear students, when something is happening right now in front of you, then we make use of present continuous tense. In Hindi, the sentence is ending with raha hai, rahi hai, rahe hai. The work which is in continuation, the work which is in progress, we use present continuous or present progressive tense to explain them. Okay, now dear students, talking about the rule, how to apply this one present continuous tense, dear students, rule goes, first of all, we'll write the subject. Subject can be anyone. Then, plus helping verb. Now you need to pay attention on this. Is, am, are the helping verbs? Is used with he, she, it and name. I have mentioned in the picture. Am is used with I and are is used with you, we and they. Please remember. And then we use main verbs first form plus ing. ing is very important in present continuation. And then you can add object with it. For example, now we'll make a sentence. He is reading a book. He is reading a book. He is the subject. Is the helping verb. Reading is the main verb's first form plus ing. And book is a object. Now, I am teaching you. I am the subject. Am is the helping verb. Teaching is the main verb plus ing. And you are the object. Okay, dear students. Now talking, this was the example of affirmative sentence or positive. Now I'm going to tell you about negative. Don't worry. Just what we need to do while framing a negative sentence, dear students. What you need to do is just add not after the helping verb. So the rule will become subject plus plus helping verb plus not plus main verb's first form, then ing and object. So it will become like, he is not reading a book. He is not reading a book. Now, dear students, moving on to interrogative. Interrogative in which you can answer yes or no. So, here I've already told you, you're going to interchange the place of the subject and the helping verb. So, either of the is, am, are, whichever the sentence, depending upon the subject, will come in front and the subject will move at the second place. So, it will become like, are you coming? Are you coming? So you'll answer in yes or no. Then moving on to double interrogatives, in which yes and no cannot be the answer. You have to utter some words. So in that case, only WH family will get attached to the rule. So like the rule will become WH family plus helping verb plus subject plus main verbs first form plus ing and then object. For example, where are you going? Where are you going? Okay, so I've explained all the four categories. Now I'm going to tell you, dear students, I'm going to tell you about the uses, like what are the applications where you can use these sentences. First of all, dear students, these sentences are more commonly used when something is happening, like some action is in progress. For example, I'm teaching you, he's reading a book, we are watching television, anything which is happening in progress right now, which action is in progress. Another example where these type of sentences are used is, dear students, if like action or event that will continue for some time, for example, I am making a program. Probably it is not completed right now, it would take some time. For example, they are building a house. So house is not built in a day, no, it is going to take time. So something is in continuation. So we say, so these, dear students, like this process will continue for some more time. So another example is this one. Now moving on to third one, dear students, it finds its application where we need to explain any action that is planned to take place in near future. For example, the president is arriving next week. The schools are going to open. Schools are opening in July. Anything which is coming in recent near future. Okay. And the very last application is, dear students, you always use it with. While expressing our irritation, and when we use always, then also we can make present continuous tenses. For example, she is always complaining about one thing or the other. He is always disturbing. But no, all of you are very sweet. I'm just joking. Yes, so these were the examples, dear students. Hope you like the video. And I just gave my best, whatever I can give in present continuous tense. Hope you like it. And be ready for my next video. I'll be soon coming again with present perfect tenses. Thank you. Have a very good day. Bye-bye.